Hey everyone, Daniel here from Twin Bytes with another tutorial for you. This time on how to create your own bootable USB toolkit that will have a countless number of tools and utilities on there to do and fix just about anything. So stick around. Everyone, welcome back. If you're new to this channel, consider hitting the like button and subscribe, and don't forget to ring the bell to be notified every time we come out with a new weekly video. So the toolkit that you can create yourself, rather than buying some of these online that they're claiming can fix anything, nothing's really automatic. You need to do certain things, and you got to get the right tool for the job. So using this free utility from Pendrivelinux.com. I'll have the links all below in the description as well for everything that we cover in this video. The program here is called Yumi. And now, previous to this, there was a bootable USB we could do that would have one ISO file that would allow you to boot one particular program or operating system from that drive. But with this one, we can have multiple ISO files, which allows us to have multiple installations for various operating systems and programs. So we're going to go through this here. The first thing is downloading this program. So when you go to pendrivelinux.com, and on the main page, if you scroll down a bit, we'll see the download link here for Yumi, and it shows the current version that they're on. So you would download that, save that, and we'll run it. Now, before we get into that, you also want to be able to download all your other ISO files, which you can download a series of different ones, including Windows, Linux, and other bootable tools, which I will link to as well in the description down here. If you want one of the most common things, especially for me, and if you're a technician trying to reinstall Windows so many times, is having a copy of Windows 10. So if you just look, do in a Google search even, but I'll have the link below again, is to search for the Windows 10 Media Creation Toolkit. And so you'll be able to go down below here. It says download the tool now. So when you download that and run it, it will prompt you to either create a bootable ISO file for use on another machine or to install or update your current machine. Now, I've gone to some other sites and downloaded a couple of other tools as well. So you can see here I've got Yumi already. I've got Windows 10 as well as the 32 and 64-bit combined. I've also downloaded the latest copy of Ubuntu as well as Memtest, which is great for testing your memory. So starting off here, we're going to run Yumi and agree. This is where we choose the boot drive. Now yours will have some drive letter show up and whatever the name is that's associated with it. I've already used mine as a multi-boot, so it says that already, but yours may say something different. So what we want to do is check to format as NTFS. Now, the problem, if you choose 32-bit, it limits the size of the biggest type of file that you can store on that flash drive. So I would recommend doing NTFS, so that way you can also store other files of various file size. Now the next part is choosing what you want to install on here, because after it formats it, it's going to start installing the first tool. So we'll go with something small here. So the first thing would be our memory test. But let's have a quick search through here. There's the various versions of Ubuntu 32 and 64-bit. Of course, they've got them all listed here. There's Linux, CentOS, Debian. So basically a whole pile of Linux, Puppy Linux, it's all Linux. Other distros, which just means other distributions of Linux. which are not as popular, but there's a ton of them, as you can see. There's anonymous browsers. There's a whole bunch of antivirus tools in here that you could download as well, which is great for scanning for viruses offline. Not just offline, but because it says offline here. But all of the antivirus here, you would be running from a bootable USB, so the operating system isn't running while it's scanning for viruses, and that way it can detect things better. Also, there's a whole bunch of different tools here as well that you'll find. And there's our memory test, although that one doesn't work with this. I'll explain in a moment. There's other OS tools, the Windows installers, which we're going to get to that. This would be the Windows 7, 8, and 10 installer for a single one. Or if you're doing a multi-boot, there's a couple of options on there. If we want to look at the Ubuntu, there is the Ubuntu option. And it tells you here to browse and select the ISO. So we'll go to browse, and there is the Ubuntu ISO. Now, although it's showing in this folder where I'm at, it has to show all the file types that are ISO. It's only showing the one that is to do with Ubuntu, because that's what we're trying to get, because I selected to make that one specifically. If I scroll down to the bottom here and go to a single Windows 10 installer and go to browse, it shows me all of the ISO files, and then I can choose either the single one or the 3264-bit. I'm going to go with the memory test to do that one first. And the thing is with that, if we go to the system tools and choose memtest, it wants to look for the memtest 5 plus zip file. Now, that's not the one that I downloaded. I don't have the zip file. I have an ISO file, and it's 4.37, and this is the latest version of the memtest 86. So I got this from a different location than what they are expecting. But there is a link here to go to the page that they're expecting so we can get the correct one. So let's do that. So this is a different looking page than what I was on previously. They had the memtest and memtest 86, so they were different products basically, but they do the same thing and they look pretty well the same. So on this site we would scroll down quite far until we get to the download section for download and pre-built and ISOs. So it's got the memtest 86 plus, and that's what we're looking for. And here's the latest ones here. This is the zip format that we want. Let's browse. And it doesn't show the zip file still, even though that's the one that it's looking for. So there's something not working with that method. So the way to get this memtest installed, whether we're using the memtest 86 or the 86 plus, when we go into select what type we're using, we don't have to choose any specific thing. There's unlisted ISO file types here. So they got the partition 4, or just grub from RAM, or syslinux. If you're not sure which one to use, you can probably just go with the ISO grub. Then we can go to browse, and here is our all of the ISO files that I have listed, including the one here that I had originally. So we'll open that, and this is all we needed to do. So we're ready to begin the formatting and installation of our first ISO file. So we'll hit create. And it gives you a warning, so make sure you read this, back up anything that you've got, and if you've got everything backed up that you needed from the drive and you're fine with wiping it, then go ahead and hit yes to begin. And this will take a few minutes because it has to prepare format it, and install all the bootable components to make the USB bootable. And then once it's in a bootable state, then it starts adding your first ISO file. And depending on how big that is, that can take a little bit longer as well. So I'm going to skip through to the end of this because there's really nothing else you need to do until it's completed the formatting and adding of the first ISO file. Okay, so you can see here that it's finally done. It went through everything, including adding the ISO file. So we'll hit next. And when we're done this part, it asks you if you wanted to add any more ISO files, or if you're done and that's all you wanted to do was the one for now, then you can hit no. I'm going to hit yes. And then we'll just go in here and we'll choose our next ISO file. We're not choosing what file format because it's going to wipe the drive, and we don't want to wipe it. We just want to add. So if we were to click up here, view or remove installed distros, if I can speak, when we click that, we just see the drop down menu here and it shows us what's currently installed. So we'll get the others installed and then you'll see what when they're all showing here. So with that unchecked, we can go to do the next one, which is Ubuntu, and then I can go to browse and select my Ubuntu ISO file, and it's ready to go, and we can create that, and it's going to start adding that to it without erasing the first one that we had. And now that the ISO is in there for that, I'll hit next. And again, it asked me if I wanted to add in any more distros. So I think I will go ahead and I'm going to add in the final one. So again, if we're not sure we remember what's in there, we can go to view and we can see we've got the two in here. So I want to add Windows. I'll uncheck this. And scrolling down to the bottom, because I remember Windows is here, and it's the single version of 7, 8, or 10. And I'll browse for that ISO, and I'm going to do the full 32 and 64 in this case. And we don't have enough space on this particular one. So let's go with the other one. And that looks like that's going to be fine, so we'll create with that. Okay, now that that's finally done, we can hit next. And it asked me if I want to add any more ISO distros. I'll say no, because I'm finished with that. And we're finished. So if I wanted to review them, I could have hit yes to add more and just not add them and cancel, but I can launch the program here and go back into it. Select the drive and then view. Now in the drop down menu, I can see I've got the three different ISO files that I've added in here. And so now what we can do is cancel out of there, and we'll take this USB drive from here and plug it into another machine and boot it from there so that you can see how that works. All right, so with our USB plugged in, when you boot up the computer, you may have to press delete or F2 to get in the BIOS, and then you can go into your boot menu, which I have a button for, and then I can choose what device I want to boot from. So selecting the USB, it now boots it into Yumi, and we can see we've got all our options with a countdown going at the bottom. So you've got 30 seconds to hit the up and down arrow at least to select something else to stop the counter. Then you've got all the time in the world to choose an option. Going into the Windows installers, we can see all the different type of Windows operating systems that we can install. We can go back to our main menu and check out all the Linux distributions that we have on here, all one of them. And we'll go back to the main menu. And finally, if you remember, we had to use grub as an unlisted ISO when we did our mem test. So it'll list all the different ISOs installed under this category, and there's all one of them, the memtest. So we can just highlight that and hit enter. We don't need to do anything else from this menu here. You can ignore these options. It'll choose the defaults and just begin testing the memory. So this is really cool if you wanted to test the memory on your computer and see if it's healthy. So you can add as many ISO images as your hard drive has the storage to handle and add all kinds of tools and utilities on there. So if you found this helpful, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and hit that bell to be reminded every time we come up with a new video. And let me know in the comments below what other tools and utilities do you think you would like to add onto this device. And would you like to see in a tutorial video on any of those particular tools and how to use them? We've done one on this memtest a while back, but we can do many others here. That's it for this tutorial. Thanks so much for watching, and we will see you in the next one. Bye for now.